like learn from other people. It's like you learn from me. I'm learning from you. I learn from someone else. You learn from someone. Like, did you just wake up one day and just learn how to do permanent makeup? You got help, right?
Yeah, I woke up with a tattoo machine in my hand.
So yeah, it goes back like I don't know about you, but I see it a lot with spa owners. They're just scared to ask for help. They're kind of just think I'm the best. Like I'm a spa owner. They think I have to be able to do everything. I just know it all. Like, were you ever in like a situation where you were kind of like brand new? Like, I got this. I could do it like all on my own.
No, it wasn't so much. Yeah, I mean, I've been feeling I can do it on my own because I'm a confident person, but. I also realized that in the middle of this, it's not that easy to do by yourself. You can go at it all gung-ho and thinking you're going to do it by yourself, but it only works so far. It works for a while, but unless you do something else also, it's not going to work just being alone. A lot of people don't want to admit that they're not making it. So they hang in there, and they don't do anything because they think they have no money. I can't do anything. And then they lose everything because they don't want to ask for help or try something new.
It's like they've dug themselves a little hole, and instead of just reaching their hand out, it's that they keep digging down into the point like they can't get out. And I've seen that.
That's what fear.
Fear.
People are afraid. And intimidated. They don't want to tell anyone that my spa is not going too well. And when I meet all the girls in these groups and I say, hey, how's your spa going? And they're like, well, you know, yeah, it's going great. And I'm thinking, okay, because I'm thinking I'm pretty slow. It's strange that they're doing so good. Then I ask another one, oh yeah, it's really good. Then all of a sudden, because I'm asking so many, someone is saying, you know what? I've been really slow. I said, really? Because that's interesting. I thought that was the only one. But I know I'm not.
Of course not. Well, yeah, and it goes like, at least with you, you went from slow to no longer slow, right? You went from like getting business, and it's because you asked for help. You went from, instead of digging that hole deeper, saying, oh, I can figure this out. I'm losing money every single month, but it's fine. I'll be okay. I'll figure it out. No, you stuck out your hand. You said, please help me. I'm willing to take this. I'm not scared. I'm scared to lose my business, but I'm not scared to take this leap forward and to ask for help.
Yeah. And you know, another thing that I think is really nice, you have to ask for help. But also, I feel like when I started with the Spa Rocket, there's things that you kind of have to teach each other from the beginning. Even when you get help, you have to share some things with other people, you know, with the people you work with, because otherwise they won't know. You have to tell where you're living. I talked to Neda. I said, Neda, I want you to look at the map. Okay. I said, look there. Let's open this. She's looking at the map. I said, that's my spa. Exactly pointed it out on the map. I said, go further down. I said, guess who lives there? I said, she goes, no, I do. So I'm showing, we're looking at everything. I said, you know, and now we have to think about, you know, what are my fees? You know, what are my services? How much am I willing to bring my prices down and things like that? But you also have to look for the right audience. Because if you're in the wrong area, sending in the wrong directions for Facebook, you are going to end up in maybe something with people that doesn't even speak your language and really can't afford to do a whole lot. So you have to look at where you actually are turning your head to send your rocket. You don't want to throw the rocket in the wrong direction. So
exactly.
That's a good thing too.
Yeah, and that's like why we do. It's not like we're just like a marketing company. Like we're partnering up with you. We're invested just as much as you are, because like if you're not happy, we lose you as a client. So it makes no sense to have you unhappy. Like we do everything we can. Like if it means we hop on a call with you for an hour to do it, like we do it, because it's relationships that matter, because that's how you get happy clients. And that's how we help you. That's how we have the most impact possible, create this ripple effect where you make more, you help your community, you help other people. And it just goes, and it's fucking crazy.
Yeah. And that's what it is. And another thing is really cool that it's always pleasant to talk to you all. Always. It's uplifting. It's cheery. It's fun. It's not some old grumpy gray thing sitting there telling me, I'm sorry, I don't think this is going to work. No, it's always, let's go, let's do it.
Well, we're fun. That's the way it's got to be. Business has to be fun.